Hello, welcome to Rosa TV, the place where you learn scientifically proven ways to help your children to build better literacy skills. Today we are going to talk about how can we help your children to learn literacy skills in a more effective way. And if we want to talk about that, we cannot skip simple view of reading. So as you can see on the screen now, we can see on the x-axis we have word recognition. On y-axis we have language comprehension. So let's focus on the x-axis first, which is word recognition. And the skills that it involves in word recognition include decoding skills and phonological awareness skills and also sight recognition. Now, scholars give these kind of skills a lot of big names, but actually they are very simple. So when we talk about decoding, the main idea you can think about is like letter sound knowledge or phonics. So that's step one. So that's the skill to build word recognition skills. That's number one. But you can see in this row, it takes two skills in order to help children to build good reading comprehension skills. And the second skill is language comprehension. And I would like to spend some time to talk about this because this is really important. And if you ask me whether there are enough evidence in the literature regarding whether phonics is a good way to support children to learn English, the answer is yes. We get lots of good research showing that in order to help children to build solid, good literacy skills, then we need to make sure that children, when they read a new word, they are able to generate the pronunciation of the word by themselves. So that's step one. But the key take-home message is that we shouldn't just stop here. We actually need to do a lot more in order to help children to build good literacy skills, which I'm going to show you right now. Number one is background knowledge. So this includes things like how we can bring a lot more facts or concepts in our children's mind. So this can include experience like camping or some unique experience that we can share with the children. Now this is very important because if we think about when a children read a text and the text talks about camping, and the thing is, if the children don't even experience camping themselves, then it's very difficult for them to generate that emotion when they read the text. So that's number one. It would be great if we can, in our daily life, how we can include these different experiences in our children's life so that when it comes to reading comprehension, they have all these good background knowledge to support their reading. That's number one. Number two, vocabulary. And when we talk about vocabulary, it's not only important to know a lot of words, it's also important to know the depth of the words. So what I mean is, like, if I give you a word like exonerate, a lot of parents, especially Asian parents, what parents would do is to ask the child to memorize 10 new English words every day. But one thing that the literature keeps showing is that rather than focusing on 10 new English words, maybe we should focus on 3 per day. So smaller number of words, but make sure that for that 3 words, we make sure we use a lot of prompts to help our children to learn the words. So say, like, if your children learn English as a second language, then we can use their first language to help them to learn English. So say, like, my situation, my first language is Cantonese. So it's always helpful if the child already know that word in Cantonese and bring that meaning to support the child to learn English. So that's number one. But also using that word, so say, like, our example is exonerate, thinking about how can we give the child different examples of using the word exonerate. So say, like, one example can be the job of the defense attorney is to exonerate his client and keep them out of jail. So the child can see, okay, exonerate can be used in this way. But we can also show the child that exonerate can be used in another way as well. So, like, the testimony from the witness will hopefully exonerate my husband of the charges. So we are showing the child that the word exonerate can be used in different contexts. So we talk about vocabulary. Number three is language structure. So it's important for our children to learn the structure of a sentence, that it needs subject, verb, object. And I would like to talk about this together with verbal reasoning, which is using metaphors and inferencing skills. Now, I would like to talk about language structure and verbal reasoning together because these two skills, we don't need to train the children on language structure or verbal reasoning just by reading books. talks, say like if we watch TV together, it's actually very helpful if we can talk about the characters, what do our children think about how the characters are feeling right now, and what do they think about what's going to happen next. So you see, this kind of thing, we are still training the children to talk to us, to build their skills on a sentence, come in the structure in subject, verb, object, and we also building all that verbal reasoning skills just by focusing on a story with our children. So that's why I like to talk about language structure and verbal reasoning together, because these two skills, we can train them even when we are watching a movie or when we are watching TV. Lots of ways to help us to engage and build these skills with our children. And finally, it is literacy knowledge. So this is the child understanding that when they are writing different types of writing, then they will need to utilize different skills as well. So say like they will understand when they are writing a piece of argumentative work versus writing a blog, the way how they write and the way how they engage with their audience is going to be different. So having that understanding. So you might ask me, okay, so you have explained that phonics and language comprehension are both very important for reading comprehension. So is there any proof showing that if we don't use one of these skills, or if we don't have a good foundation in these two skills, then the children is going to suffer when it comes to reading comprehension? The answer is yes. And here is a paper that's published by my boss, Professor Julia Carroll, who is well known in the field of dyslexia. So what she did was she gathered the data from 270 children, and they test these children at the age of 4, 6, 7, and 8. So you can see this as a 4-year project. And she tests them on a wide range of literacy tests. And what she found was that out of these 270 children, 42 children end up having language difficulty, or you can call it dyslexia. And what she realized is that 90% of these children, they have deficit in phonological awareness, print knowledge, which is related to vocabulary skills that we talked about just now, and also rapid naming. So what we mean by rapid naming is when the children see the words, whether they are able to read aloud those words as fast as possible, and also when they see digits, are they able to read the digits as fast as possible. And also they have difficulties in verbal short-term memory and visual search. So what we call visual search is the children really need to find a particular dinosaur out of other random dinosaurs. So one key thing here is you can see that phonological awareness, print knowledge are significant factors that affect whether a children is going to have dyslexia or not. Echo what we talked about just now, we really need to help our children to build good literacy skills in both decoding and language comprehension, which includes all the skills that we talked about just now, like vocabulary, like syntax, and also verbal reasoning skills. So all these skills are required in order to help our children to build solid reading comprehension skills. So down there, I would like you to comment and to tell me, what do you think about phonics and vocabulary skills? Do you think both of these skills are very important when it comes to supporting your children's literacy skills? It would be lovely to hear from you. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.